Mr. Gadkari, Honorable Minister, Mr. Puri, and distinguished panelists, and ladies and gentlemen. On behalf of Asian Development Bank, I'd like to thank this opportunity very much, and particularly echo Junaid for congratulating AIIB for this curtain raiser ceremony. AIIB is glad to already working with the power grid project of $150 million already signed, and understand that already 70-80% of the procurement is completed. So we hope that the project can be a fast-moving project that we can work together. We also have a port project also received from DEA, and our management is keen to have directed us to work together with AIIB. So we look forward to further opportunities with the AIIB. Today I would like to cover where the India's infrastructure financing requirement is and where possibly the MDB space is. And secondly, what could be the role of MDBs, particularly if we look at the potentials expected working together with the other MDBs, as well as the crowding in the private and municipal resources. And thirdly, based on our operational strategies, what could be our approach to apply such a principle of crowding in our operations? First is with respect to Indian infrastructure. And as Honorable Minister has mentioned, there are certain gaps. We took this data from the Grid Seal, and India needs, and also the recent economic survey quotes that India needs to invest annually 12 lakh crore per year. And there's a gap of about $62 billion per year. Looking at the Grid Seal data, Honorable Minister mentioned there's a lot now taking place, the data may be too old, but highways, probably this is much more moving faster. And also the urban housing is now getting accelerated. But still, we see a lot of gaps in the urban infrastructure, railways, and to some extent highways, probably on the state highways and rural roads. So I think it is good, we are very pleased to note that the government is making very fast in some of the promising sectors like national highways, ports, but I think the MDB's role is really to look at those gap areas where there are still the gap in capacities, as well as the areas where we can bring in some new technologies. So, but still in those gap areas, we cannot work alone, we need to work together, try to do our best to particularly mobilize other private finances, municipal resources. So that I think is a key principle that we would like to apply in this environment. And so when we talk about what are the new financing opportunities for crowding in other resources, we just try to summarize some of the key emerging areas, and there's a lot of talk about the green taxation, but here in the context of urban infrastructure where there's still a gap exists, I just would like to highlight the potential for municipal resource mobilization. India's municipal bond mobilization, as well as the other municipal revenue system, is still under development, and the GDP ratio is 1%. Whereas we know that some peers, like BRICS country, is mobilizing 5% of the GDP. So this requires attention to introducing property tax systems, and I think these days Niti Aayog and the Ministry of Urban Housing Affairs Ministries pretty much focusing on the need for doing a longer term urban planning and land use planning, rationalizing or adjusting the building code, and really try to promote the vertical development of urban areas as compared with the horizontal expansion. And also, there's a lot of opportunity for land value capture. And this is pretty much important in a sense. Urban infrastructure also requires a lot of operation and maintenance activities. And one report I remember in McKinsey cited that annual maintenance requirement is as much as 40-50% of the investment requirement. So in that sense, India still needs to mobilize these property tax and longer-term land use systems to make this happen. So that's one area that I think agencies like AIIB, through urban infrastructure investment, can support. And also, there are some other financing, like this debt mobilization for PPP, equity, bonds. So there are some opportunities. That's something that we also are keen to work together with. And then lastly, I just want to touch upon what AIIB is doing in terms of trying to crowd in some of the or working together with other development organizations and crowding in other resources. This is a chart showing what's AIIB's cumulative investment. So far, 39.4 billion has been invested. And as of this moment, total of almost 80 running projects amounting 13.1 billion US dollar is ongoing. 40% transport, 20% energy, and 20% urban, and the rest is others. And we recently have a five-year partnership strategy endorsed by DEA and approved by our board. And here we are envisaging increasing annual lending, 3 billion to 4 billion. But this is, again, as compared with India's infrastructure development needs, it's a very tiny amount. So we, while focusing on key three pillars, like economic corridors, low-income states, and climate change, one of the thrusts that we are entrusted to, expected by the government, is really to catalyzing public and private co-financing. So this is one principle, and some of the efforts already made has been listed here. We have been doing quite a lot in terms of infrastructure credit lines for PPP private investments through IIFCL, IRADA, solar rooftop, and credit enhancement of project bonds has been done, and PPP, also hybrid annuity, has been also adopted in some of the states like Rajasthan and Karnataka. And the climate investment fund mobilization and urban fraud, I think the progress is still slow, but some of the advanced cities like Kolkata are willing to introduce the property tax systems on a unit rate based approach. So those initiatives are slowly going, and at this moment our approach is really to work with the governments, particularly DEAs, suggesting us to be engaged more in the strategic studies at the corridor level, strategic studies at the northeast to act east to policy implementation, as well as strategic planning at the infrastructure at the state level like UP. So we are, I just want to illustrate the economic corridor study that is going on. We are covering, supporting the Tamil Nadu, Andhra Pradesh, Odisha to prepare the economic corridor development strategies. And this has four elements. One element is land use, land identification and detailed land use planning and arranging land. Second element is the identified industrial clusters and urban areas, doing a study on the preparing project proposals for the node cluster infrastructure. Third is a trunk network infrastructure like highways, state national highways, as well as the transmission lines. And the standalone infrastructure is port, airports, supply centers, and so on. So some of the these are some planning process. So we have a futuristic plans for the transport, rail grids, port, as well as detailed land use planning for the identified industrial clusters. So this provides a very significant investment proposal. Lower bar chart is Vizag Chennai Industrial Corridor. Total investment requirement is $38 billion. So this is much, much bigger than what ADB can finance. And so the way that we are trying to help implement this corridor is in this table. So the lower part, trunk spine networks and trunk standalone projects like ports and national highways, those are something that already the Honorable Minister mentioned that they can already mobilize their own financing. So our role is more on possibly state highways and rural roads if there's opportunity exists. Whereas the urban, more cluster, industrial cluster, urban cluster investments, in the short term, I think there's a lack of bankability at this moment. So we'll start with potentially a conventional urban development project. But over the medium term, we would be willing to be engaged for the longer term planning process and also help the state and the municipalities capture land value and gradually crowding in private resources and work together. Then we will go to the other kind of working places. So those are the kind of strategy that we are working together with, and I hope that we'll have a lot of chances to work with honorable ministers, highway, as well as the urban sector for the future, and gradually attracting private investments. And I think since the strategic requirement is much, much more than ADB can, or World Bank can provide finance, there's a lot of opportunity, I believe, to work together with the AIIB and NDB and other partners. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.